He said, well, this is the soul of most Christians. You know, it looked a real mess. At the altar of incense, at the far end, I finally focused, and there was another altar, which is in the far end of this place. And it was the altar of incense. And there was smoke coming off that, and small white, like vapor, it was coming off it, which had a nice smell, but there was still a lot of smoke coming off it. When I thought, that smoke ought not to be there, you know? And the Lord said, this is the altar of incense. But there was very little incense on it. There was very little vapor coming off. But there was a lot of smoke. And I said, Lord, what is the smoke? What is this? And he said, that's the selfish prayers of my people. He said, it's just smoke in here. I said, what? I thought, man, you know, I thought we were doing well, you know. I thought, you know, selfish, you know, smoke, selfish prayers which didn't originate in him. I thought, Lord. By this time, I began to think, you know, the situation's hopeless, you know. I was getting depressed. And I said to the Lord, Lord, I really thought we were doing well, you know. He looked at me and he said, there is much in the church which is good. He said, but I must do a much deeper work of cleansing. And when he said that, I felt like... can't explain it. Something went through me like, I can't explain it. It's, something went through me. That's good enough because I can't explain it. You know, the Lord came up and he threw some incense onto that altar of incense. And the vapor came up and started to fill the place. And when he did that, a veil parted. And I thought, at this point, it's like everything stopped. And I thought, we've got to build an altar of incense to get through the veil. There's got to be an altar of incense in our hearts, or we're never going to get through the veil. It speaks of our prayer life and intercession, you know? Anyway, this came off, and again, we moved into another room. It's more, much, much smaller. And I had, as soon as I stepped into it, I had this distinct feeling, this room is very rarely visited. That was just the feeling. And the Lord Jesus stood in front of me. And then something began to happen, like kind of only happens in the movies. He started to morph and become an Ark of the Covenant, and then the Lord Jesus. The Ark of the Covenant, and then the Lord Jesus. And I thought, you know, I wish we could do this better in, you know, our studios. It's like, it was really good how he was doing this. And it was like, okay, I know, Lord, you are the Ark. I know, you are the Ark of the Covenant. We've got to follow you. And that happened three times. The room was slightly dim, but not as dim as the other two areas. And suddenly, the Lord looked at me and smiled. And he said, I can do it, you know. And then he began to emanate light. This light began to come. And I thought, whoa. It's such a power and energy came off him. To such a degree that it filled, you know, that whole place. When I got into that, that started to come over me, I had the feeling that I was standing in eternity. That was the only way I can describe it. There was no past. There was no present. I was in eternity. It was a strangest feeling. It's like time stopped. And then it's like, God, it's hard to explain. Ages, past and present, began to be merged. The future was merged into the present, the past. Galaxies flowed by me, time, immortal, eons.